Good morning, everyone. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Advent. Please kindly silence all cell phones and pages so as not to disrupt the liturgy. This Mass is being offered for Teresa Voigt. If you have any questions about parish activities, please contact the office. Reservations are necessary for attendance at Mass on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. Masses will be at 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. Christmas Eve and 10 a.m. Christmas Day. Please call the office for a reservation by Wednesday, December the 23rd at noon. There is a sign-up sheet for lectors and Eucharistic ministers for Christmas Masses on the table in the sanctuary near St. Paul's altar.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Paul's. Before Mass begins, we had a couple of announcements and reminders. Just remember to stay in your seats at all times. During communion and dismissal, you will be told where to go by the ushers. Please keep your masks on at all times. Because singing is the way that the virus spreads the easiest, please refrain from singing during the Mass. On our YouTube channel, we have a celebration of lessons and carols, which is about an hour of the readings and songs about Christ's coming. With all that being said, please rise as our liturgy begins.
Let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My friends, the Lord is with you. Once again, we come to the Lord's table, getting ever closer to the celebration of his birth. As we prepare for his coming, let us go into our hearts and ask our Lord to remove any feelings of ill will, impatience, jealousy, and replace them with his loving kindness and healing. Father, we are sorry for our sins because we love you. We ask you to give us your peace and healing through the sacrament we're about to receive. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the messenger and angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up from your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. He will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. The promise of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, forever will I confirm with your posterity and establish your throne for all generations. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. He shall say of me, "You are my Father, my God, the rock, my Savior." Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm. Forever I will sing of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings, and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith. To the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. Coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. You shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "But how can this be, since I've had no relations with a man?" But the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. It's hard for us to have to wait for something, especially when there seems to be no answers or when we can't understand why it's happening to us. And I think of Mary, a little girl, being told that she's to be a mother, but not the mother of just anybody, but the mother of the Son of God. Well, her wait is almost over. In a few days, we'll celebrate that day when she actually gave birth to that baby. And in spite of all the questions she had, all the doubts that troubled her mind, the answers would be soon to come. And even after that was answered, there'd be still more worries, more questions, difficulties for the rest of her life and the life of her son. But as we prepare for this holy day on Christmas, let us just take a look at our own lives and remember how Jesus has always been there for us, and especially times when we had doubts or we had questions where there were no answers. Let us stand in prayer. Father, we come before you now with many prayers and many needs. We ask you to listen to them and grant them according to your will.
As we prepare to celebrate Christmas, let us remember the gift we can be for each other. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the end to the coronavirus, through the healing power of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for our new bishop-elect, Michael Fisher, that he may be blessed with the ability to lead our diocese, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve our country, that God may keep them safe, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially those near death, that they may see in their suffering a share in the passion of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who have died, might rejoice in seeing God face to face, the recently deceased, and for Teresa Voigt, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own particular intentions of this day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Our final prayer for the lighting of the Advent wreath. Emmanuel, God with us, through you we lift up to the Father a world desperately in need of healing. As we wait in joyful hope for your coming once more, may you never cease to guide and direct your church, who live and reign forever and ever.
What do you want of me, Lord? Where do you want me to serve you? Where can I sing my praises? I am your song, and I am moved Spirit stirs my deepest self. Sing your songs in me.
Sacrifice in yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May this Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We make our prayers, we ask all things through Christ our Lord. The Lord is with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Jesus our Lord and Savior. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that we already rejoice in the mystery of the Nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalted in praise. And now with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, sanctus, sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plena sunt caelia terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, you are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Mortem tuam annunciamus Domine, et tuam resurrectionem confitemur.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks you found us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, all our bishops and all your clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all your saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as members of one family, we pray to our Father in heaven with the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, glory are yours, now and forever. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever. And my friends, may the peace of Christ be with you always. And let us offer to each other a greeting of Christ's peace.
On you stay, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord is with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon us now and remain with us forever. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another. And everyone have a good week.
Lift up your hearts and sing, you people, let the King.